Good afternoon, and welcome to St. Agnes Parish. Today we celebrate the 30th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We have the following announcements. Please pray for the repose of the souls of John Caruso and Kathleen Streets, who died recently. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. May they rest in peace. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Benedictine Father Sean Anderson and team will lead a night of healing prayer November 3rd at 6:30 p.m. here at St. Agnes. The evening will include Eucharistic exposition, corporate prayer for healing, and individual prayer ministry. If you would like to be a part of the training for a prayer team, please join us Sunday at 3:30 p.m., sponsored by Hem of His Garment Healing Ministry. Information about submitting a photo for the directory for those who are unable to be photographed at church is available in the narthex. Wednesday is the deadline. Masses for the Solemnity of All Saints, a holy day of obligation, will be celebrated at 7, noon, and 6:30 p.m. on Friday. The Mass for All Souls Day, with the reading of the names of this year's deceased, will take place on Saturday at the 8 a.m. Mass. We hope you will join us as we pray for our beloved dead. Please silence electronic devices and prepare your hearts for worship as we stand and recite the prayer for Eucharistic revival. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, you are the living bread who satisfies. In the Eucharist, and strengthen us as members of the church, the body of Christ, as we encounter. Of our brothers and sisters here and everywhere throughout the world. Help us to reveal your love, your promise, your presence to them by our lives and in all we say and do. Our gathering song can be found in your gather book, number 645, Amazing Grace. The alternate words to verse 1 are on the monitor.
Fears relieved. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, good evening.
Good evening, Father.
And welcome tonight as we anticipate this 30th Sunday in ordinary time. And tonight we hear in the gospel, I think, one of the most dramatic encounters that Mark presents us with. Jesus and this blind beggar, Bartimaeus. We can picture him on the side of the road, and his response is one of tremendous faith that Jesus says has saved him. Asking his prayers, looking to his example, we begin this liturgy first by pausing to call to mind our own sins, the ways we haven't always responded with such faith, entrusting ourselves to God's mercy that we might worthily celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King. O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son,
let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity.
and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, shout with joy for Jacob, exalt at the head of the nations. Proclaim your praise and say, the Lord has delivered his people, the remnant of Israel. Behold, I will bring them back from the land of the north. I will gather them from the ends of the world, with the blind and the lame in their midst, the mothers and those with child. They shall return as an immense throng. They departed in tears, but I will console them and guide them. I will lead them to brooks of water on a level road, so that none shall stumble. For I am a father to Israel. Ephraim is my firstborn. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. When the Lord brought back the captives of Zion, we were like men. Then our mouth was filled with laughter, and our tongue with rejoicing. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us. We are glad indeed. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the torrents in the southern desert, those that sow in tears shall reap rejoicing. The Lord has done great. Although they go forth weeping, carrying the seed to be sown, they shall come back rejoicing, carrying their sheaves.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, every high priest is taken from among men and made their representative before God to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He is able to deal patiently with the ignorant and erring, for he himself is beset by weakness, and so for this reason must make sin offerings for himself as well as for the people. No one takes this honor upon himself, but only when called by God, just as Aaron was. In the same way, it was not Christ who glorified himself in becoming high priest, but rather the one who said to him, "You are my son. This day I have begotten you." Just as he says in another place, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Your words, O Lord, are spirit and life. You have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus was leaving Jericho with his disciples and a sizable crowd, Bartimaeus, a blind man, the son of Timaeus, sat by the roadside begging. On hearing that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, "Jesus, son of David, have pity on me." And many rebuked him, telling him to be silent. But he kept calling out all the more, "Son of David, have pity on me." Jesus stopped and said, "Call him." So they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take courage, get up, Jesus is calling you." He threw aside his cloak, sprang up, and came to Jesus. Jesus said to him in reply, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man replied to him, "Master, I want to see." Jesus told him, "Go your way, your faith has saved you." Immediately he received his sight and followed him on the way. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Friends, good evening. It's nice to be with you on this beautiful fall evening. We know there are so many different kinds of gospel stories and so many different kinds of homilies. You've been listening to them your whole life, most of you. They speak to us in different ways at different times. Tonight, I want to begin with a question for you to think about. When you read the scriptures, when you pray with the scriptures, how do you do so? How do you read the scriptures? Do you allow them to come to life? Did you ever maybe close your eyes and imagine the scene, what it would be like? Or place yourself in the person in whom we encounter in the scriptures. Imagine tonight, brothers and sisters, what it must have been like for Bartimaeus, who is blind. Most of us take for granted the world that we see. Or imagine what would it be like if Jesus was passing by your place? You see, that kind of imaginative prayer, that's one of the little tricks of St. Ignatius of Loyola. He tells us that's a good way to enter into the mystery of the scriptures, to meditate and enter even into a contemplative prayer where God speaks to our hearts. On the surface, today's gospel that we listen to it's a miracle story. But more profoundly, really, it's a story about this man and his faith. And it's one of the last stories before Jesus enters into Holy Week. In fact, he's in Jericho. He's about to go up the mountain for Palm Sunday. You see, Mark's gospel that we've been listening to throughout this whole liturgical year that ends in 4 weeks is full of these short little encounters by which one comes to see who Jesus is and what it means to follow Jesus. And the story that we encounter tonight of Bartimaeus illustrates a clear faith in Jesus as the Son of David and the instrument of God's healing, saving power, and a wholehearted response. The story stands out because the protagonist is named, because of the dialogue and the depth that is present, and those things make it rich for our personal prayer. And tonight I want to walk you through just a brief reflection on some of the questions that might be raised in our hearts as we contextualize this scripture story. Right? We said we can picture Bartimaeus, this poor, blind beggar. You might imagine the person on the street when you drive into Walmart with that sign. This is his life, every day, begging. He's unjustly unemployed because of his disability. He's left, that's all he has, is to beg. Imagine what goes through his head, day after day after day, when people walk by. Yet as the number of people on the way today increases, he notices something is different this time. There's an excitement. They tell him, Jesus is coming. He's heard of Jesus. He trusts, he hopes that maybe he can heal me. He recognizes that there's something special about this Jesus, and he uses a plea that's common in the Psalms. He even calls him the Son of David, signifying his faith in the promised Messiah. You see, Bartimaeus is blind, but Mark is telling us he sees more clearly than those around him because he recognizes his need for God in his littleness. And persisting through discouragement and through rebukes, he causes quite a stir. They tell him, be quiet. And he calls out even louder, undaunted by ridicule. Let's stop here for a moment You see, the question is posed in our hearts. Where do we need to recognize Jesus coming into our lives? In our daily interactions, in our spouses, in our children, in our workplace? Are we even looking? Our faith tells us that Christ is present in his people, in the least of these. When I think of that, I tremble. So often I miss him. I have to be reminded by others or by the gospel to look for Jesus. Remember, blindness, brothers and sisters, is a theme throughout all the scriptures. It's a symbol of so many things, and including the ways that we fail to recognize Christ or live with eyes of faith. Today, this week, we might dare to ask, Lord, what is my blindness? Now, Bartimaeus, he has great faith. He believes that Jesus can do something for him. His faith prompts a question also in our hearts. Do we have that kind of faith? Do we live as if God can and does and wants to do something for us and in us? What would it look like if you took up a posture of hope and expectation before some circumstance, even some debilitating circumstance in your life? It can change the outlook, can't it? The truth is that Jesus wants, brothers and sisters, to intervene in our lives. And Bartimaeus, from a posture of humility, is deeply aware of his brokenness, of his needs. He's unafraid to cry for mercy, for pity. What about us? What places, relationships, wounds should we call out to Jesus and invite him? Finally, Bartimaeus is courageous with all of his hecklers. There's so many things in our lives that act as a voice of discouragement. It's everywhere. It can be crippling. How do we deal with discouragement in life and in faith? Bartimaeus doesn't let the naysayers win. He's persistent and confident and courageous. In contrast, those who are following Jesus have not yet learned, even at this late stage in the game, to bring people to Jesus. They become an obstacle. It says there's a huge crowd. Instead, they're sending him away. And then only when Jesus says, well, call him. Did you notice how quickly they change? Oh, they go from, hey, quiet, shut up, to, hey, look, Jesus is calling, come on up. Have we been fickle? Are we afraid of recognizing faith and then quick to turn around? Are we merciful? How can each of us be a son or daughter of encouragement? So we continue the gospel story. Something incredible happens. Jesus hears the plea of Bartimaeus and calls for him, and he responds with this enthusiastic, decisive faith. It says, he threw off his cloak, sprang up, and came to Jesus. That sounds like a minor detail, but it's actually really important because in his poverty, his cloak is the only thing that he owns. He literally leaves everything he has to follow Jesus. The fathers of the church tell us it's an image also of our baptismal garment by which we leave our old self behind and in a willing faith run to Christ. Can you think of a time when you've responded in faith, or maybe where God is inviting you to do that now? Remember that Jesus calls him by name, Bartimaeus. It's one of the only times that happens in Mark's gospel. The prefix bar, it means the son of. But his name is more than son of Timaeus. The word Timaeus means honor. The blind man is a son of honor. It doesn't seem like an honored position to be a blind beggar on the side of the street. Yet he's honored for his faith. Jesus honors him by calling him out. And his name plays into the next sentence. Jesus asks, "What do you want me to do for you?" If you remember, we heard the same question last week, where James and John were seeking to get ahead. But how different this time. Bartimaeus, rather than asking for power and honor, asks for wholeness, integrity. "Master, I want to see." And then immediately, in humility, Jesus, it says, his sight is restored and he follows him. It was both an honor and a turning point of his life. Brothers and sisters, Mark has placed this gospel story here at this point in the gospel. It's the last part before Jesus goes into Jerusalem and the whole turning point of the gospel. Jesus is going to the cross and resurrection. And the journey is framed, this little part of Mark's gospel, by two stories of healing blind people, symbolizing that it's all about healing the disciples' ability, their spiritual blindness, and the woundedness that comes from sin. And yet they still don't grasp who Jesus is, what it means to follow him. Only after the resurrection will their eyes be opened. And here it's actually the blind man who sees who Jesus is. It's the first time Jesus is identified as the son of David. That's what makes him a son of honor. Remember in Mark's gospel, the question was, who is Jesus? Who is Jesus? Who is Jesus? And finally here, right before the passion, Bartimaeus gives the answer. What was hidden in secret is proclaimed from the rooftops. In the end, lastly, Jesus says that his faith has saved him. It was his trust in God that both healed and saved him. In Greek, the word is the same, healed and saved. He's healed physically, but the eyes of his heart, his faith, have been enlightened by Jesus, and he is saved by recognizing his identity and mission. He demonstrates for us the perfect response of faith. The fact that his name is recorded suggests that he became a disciple and the early church knew him well. Final thought, friends, tonight we hear from the letter to the Hebrews about the high priest who was taken from among men, called by Jesus, as was Aaron. God still speaks in the midst of our hearts. He calls to us, each of us, by name in baptism, in the priesthood of all believers, to offer sacrifice for our sins. May we listen and respond. The letter of the Hebrews also reminds us of our humanity and of ministerial priests, different in kind, who are called from families, from among men, in the words of the Hebrews. Today's gospel invites us to pray for vocations to holy orders, or our second reading. The priest who, though beset by weakness, offers sacrifice for sins and helps us all to gain spiritual sight. Thank you for your prayers. Keep them coming. Friends, as we revisit tonight's gospel, we too have the grace every day and in this Eucharist to recognize Jesus in our daily lives. May we never be afraid to call out to him. May we respond with promptness and eagerness and vigor to the invitation of the Christian life, following Jesus more closely each day. And may this Eucharist help us heighten our senses to do just that. Amen.
Of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God,
begotten, not made,
consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven.
By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate from the Virgin Mary, and became man.
For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Confident in the Lord's goodness and care, let us raise before the Son of David our petitions for the church and the world.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For all priests taken from among men to offer sacrifices for sin, may they be continually renewed in the grace of holy orders to shepherd God's people, and may many young men hear and respond generously to God's call on their hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who, like Bartimaeus, long to see the light of God's truth, may the Holy Spirit heal blindness and lead them to know and love Christ more deeply. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the Lord help each of us, especially during this Respect Life month, to understand more deeply the challenges of pregnant and parenting mothers, and so grow in compassion, care, and support. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have been displaced from their homes by war or conflict or other circumstances, may the Lord protect them and bring them back in safety. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this assembly, may the grace of the sacraments strengthen us in faith and virtue. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially for those buried from our parish this past year, and for the deceased members of the Simcoe and Thornton families, who is remembered at this Mass, may God have mercy on them and receive them into his heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, in your graciousness, have pity on these humble prayers we offer. Heal and save us and answer them in accordance with your holy will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our song during the presentation of gifts can be found in your gather book, number 651, Open Our Eyes.
Help me to see your face.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and of all of his holy church.
Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come.
And therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, and Larry, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saints Peter and Paul, Saint Mark, Saint Agnes of Rome, and with all the saints. We shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
After the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distresses, we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall. We will ring out our joy at your saving help and exult in the name of our God. Our communion song can be found in Breaking Bread, number 329, Vine and Branches.
Remain.
remain in me as I remain in you. You will bear great fruit in me. Let us continue in breaking bread with number 400, petition. The refrain will be sung twice each time. Mercy on us all, grant us your peace, bring us your healing. O Lord, have mercy on us all, grant us your peace, bring us your healing. Who tend the sick with love that knows no fear, befriend her at their side, and for the suffering ones who lean into your care, with healing now mercy on us all, grant us your peace, bring us your healing. Lord, have mercy on us all, grant us your peace, bring us your healing. For those who child with patience keeping watch, refresh their weary minds, and for the hungry ones who lean on them to learn, prepare them in your time. Mercy on us all, grant us your peace, bring us your healing. O Lord, have mercy on us all, grant us your peace, bring us your healing.
Let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs, we may one day possess in truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
During this last week of the month, Sunday of the month, we recognize anyone celebrating an October wedding anniversary. Anybody like my parents get married in October? How many years? 38. She's the same. That's good. 55. 53. Anybody else? Congratulations. Congratulations.
Let's ask God's blessings on them. Lord and God, Creator, we bless and praise your name. In the beginning you made man and woman, that they might enter a communion of life and love. You likewise bless the union of these couples, that they might reflect the union of Christ with his church. Look with kindness on them today. Amid the joys and struggles of their lives, you have preserved the union between them. Renew now their marriage covenant. Increase your love in them and strengthen their bond of peace, so that surrounded by those they love, they may always rejoice in the gift of your blessing. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Again, happy anniversary. It's a busy week. Tomorrow, of course, the Trunk or Treat, All Saints and All Souls Day on Thursday and Friday, Christian Mothers Vendor Fair, Generations of Faith. And as the administrator of Ascension Church, I have to invite you to the spaghetti dinner drive-through on Tuesday. They're known for their meatballs. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
From Gather, let us go forth singing number 590, Christ Be Our Light.
Longing for light, we wait in darkness. Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people. Light for the world to see. Christ be our light. Shine in our hearts. Shine through the darkness. Christ be our light. Shine in your church. Gather today. Longing for peace, our world is troubled. Longing for